So there's like one thing that I really don't like about this Code of Bell 4020X. It's actually a Double Name Project 2. It's the second Double Name Project they've done. I wasn't around really paying attention on the first iteration of this, but this is a collaboration between Harvest Label, a Japanese brand, and Code of Bell. They just worked. What Code of Bell did was they worked on a previous Harvest Label bag, added some Code of Bell awesomeness to it, and this is what we have. So this video is gonna be a walkthrough of this bag just to see how awesome it really is. Let's get to it. So I just got this one, and honestly, a big thanks to Code of Bell for sending this out. I kind of just reached out to him and said, hey, dude, do you want a video on this thing? Because it looks amazing and it does not disappoint. Now let's get right to the one thing that I just don't like. And there is a bunch of little pockets on this front flap here, which we'll talk about. But this one pocket on the side, which is full length of this flap here, I was like, oh, if my iPad mini fits in there, this is gonna be the best bag ever. Bummer, it doesn't. But it does fit a Kindle, so if you're a Kindle person and you wanna travel with that, great, but iPad mini won't fit in here. But don't worry, I have it somewhere else. But I just thought that pocket would be awesome for that. But anyway, this thing is mostly Echo Pack, and then a 500D, I believe, along the bottom. So, very distinctive pack, 30 liters, and I'm gonna go through the outside-inside features, and then I'm gonna talk about comparisons, but spoiler alert, there really isn't a great comparison to this bag, just because it has a ton of things to it in a 30-liter size, but I did find a couple, don't worry, we'll get to that a little bit later. So, the one thing you'll notice, it's got this top, you know, it is removable, so you have kind of two looks about this thing. This is either a protective cover with a top pocket, which, you know, I'm a big fan of, has a pocket on the inside, which is sizable. Put your, you know, a lot of stuff in here. Another cool thing about this bag is it's got this camo orange on all the inside that you've seen on a lot of the bags and the cross pod and some other things. Really, they put it on all their bags, and it's really, really nice and really cool. There's a bunch of design cues from the old bomber jackets, World War II and beyond, that we'll talk about here in a second. There's really a distinctive feature on the front that we'll definitely highlight. But anyway, this thing is completely removable. So if you don't like this thing, Velcro and some buckles in the back, and then of course, Fidlocks in the front, this thing will just completely be removed. And so if you don't like that look, but you just wanted this, I think it was gonna get in your way, which, you know, I'm kind of undecided. I do love a top pocket, so I may just keep it on there. And I just love the Fidlocks, but of course these just come off with little G-hooks, and then you're done. Other than that, we have three sort of areas to kind of talk about. We have a back laptop area, we have a main compartment, and then we have the front area with just a lot of stuff going on. Well, we kind of have a bottom section, which of course we'll talk about. But in the very front, some very cool standout features. Little Hypalon, nice little tabs here. You can do some other stuff in here, but we've got a magnetic enclosure for another top pocket, but a nice little drop-in pocket. This is a case to the max size iPhone. Nice little orange accent, quad lock, but that's how deep this thing goes. So if you've got the max size iPhone, you can put it right in there and it'll fit nicely. But you have a nice little pocket on the top for that. Then you have two pockets that go on this side and one that's over here. Kind of already talked about this pocket, perfect size for a Kindle. It's just a much taller pocket. There's one thing I didn't talk about though, besides the fact that it fits a Kindle, is it does have a Fidlock button style magnetic key. So if you're a key person, put them on here and tuck it away Maybe just put some other taller stuff in there. Maybe put your phone in that side because you'd be able to access it without opening the top. If that's the way you want to roll with that. So super cool, right? Taller items on this side. The zipper kind of got buried. On this side, we have two other pockets, two shallower pockets. What would you put in here? I mean, I don't know, maybe you put your wallet in here. But in this top one, didn't put anything in that one. This lower one, I just had some charging peripherals. So maybe this is where you put a little charging accessory and some other stuff. So just smaller deck of cards would fit in there for sure. But you're sandwiched in between a couple layers. More about that here in a little bit. On the sides, we have two bottle pockets, which just fold into the bag if you're not gonna use them, which is super cool. Everything's got this Echo Pack. It's got a little stretchiness to the back so you can fit some bigger things in there. We've got these, they're tied in, they're not removable. These are the coolest Fidlocks. I don't have a lot with this design, but they just slide away and then you can buckle them straight in. That's how they do the compression on this side. So this is, you know, big enough for a tripod. Bury the tripod in here and then, you know, have it stick out the top and then secure it with this, you know, this Fidlock system. Now you have to undo the Fidlocks to get in the main compartment. That's one thing to think about there. We do have other tie-in points and just all sorts of stuff. I'm not really sure what this one's for, but it is cool. All sorts of little tie-ins, which I just haven't figured out yet. Just got this thing. And this, on this side, same deal. These don't go all the way to the bottom because this whole bottom pocket thing, which is a nice little feature that you can use or not use the way it's designed. More about that here in a second. So big, taller bottles will fit. You can tie it in there and we have this nice little D-ring for some other security. So it's kind of nice and super cool. Little branding on this side, zippers, Hypalon for the laptop area. Now, laptop area, let's just get it out of the way. It's good. And there's two areas. There's a bigger area with, of course, this is where we see some more branding. And I got just the 13-inch MacBook. Your bigger laptops will for sure fit, but we'll try to fold this down so we can get to this back panel. And that's where we see the Double Name Project 2, Harvest Label, Cotabel, Osaka, and Los Angeles. So that's just cool, right? More of that orange camo-ness, which is cool. So you really have two areas in here, which I really don't know why I would want another area, because I'm going to put my laptop in here. This bigger area is not elevated. So maybe put a taller item in here. I just haven't figured out a real good use for that space. And it just takes away from the main compartment in my world. So it is what it is. You like it? Cool. Put a jacket in there. Some other quick access item. I think that's one way to do it. So handles, we have just a, we'll talk about the back here in a little bit. We have one bottom handle that's kind of on this bottom area. And then we have the top handle, nice padded on the back, way overkill and nice, super nice and padded if you needed to carry it. There's a little bit of foam in there, so it's nice and cushioned. This little, the lid we've kind of talked about, but it's got some shock cord in there. It's stretchy, so you could put your jacket or some other bigger item on the top. Another little thing, which is super cool. And again, it's completely removable. Talk about the back panel here in a second. The bottom area is sort of one of its stand up features. It does tend to stand. Now, what I have in there is kind of preventing it from standing, but I had some other stuff in there and it will stand. It's got a nice big wide base, right? Look at the bottom. It's just super wide and durable. Nice little handle, like I said. And then what you'll notice is there's drain plugs, drain holes, drain screens on the bottom, which are nice. Because the way this is designed, and I believe it's the way it's conceived, is that you can use this as like the shoe area. So use it for everyday carry and put your shoes on the bottom. Or don't use it that way. So if you had some stuff in there that were, you know, maybe your dirty laundry, or if you wanted to put your wet shoes in there, you're gonna either vent or drain out a little bit. The drain holes really are not drain holes, more kind of vent the stinkiness of it. But as you see here, I'm totally not using that feature. So it's got this layer here that you either push out with other stuff and don't even use that part of the bag. Or if you're going to, then you're just put less stuff in here. But if you don't want to use this area, then you just got this whole thing decked out the way you see it here, which is, I think, you know, it's a nice little feature that if you didn't like it, it, you know, totally melts into the bag and you don't even have to use it. So you just kind of use it however you want. And the zipper are on both sides, so you can go to one side or the other. So you got zippers on both sides, so you can, you know, access that however you want. Now the back panel is really, really cool and really, really comfortable. We have the X-Pack brought all the way around the front. We have strap keepers tied into the bottom. We have a built-in sternum strap. We have Coat of Bell branding on one side, Harvest label on the other. We have a little place to tuck in the straps from the top part. We have D-rings for additional attachment points. We also have, and they're tucked away in here, the ability to put some sort of waist belt in there if you wanted to clip something. Not included with this, but you could totally do that. There is a luggage pass through or a handle, you know, nice. We have a honeycomb mesh foam padding that's kind of built into this, which makes this thing really, really comfortable when you carry it. A little bit of breathability as well. And then that kind of continues on the back. It's not honeycomb, but it is some sort of spacer 3D kind of mesh in there. Very, very comfortable. It's not terribly wide, but it is nice shape to it, which makes it really comfortable, in my opinion. So really, really well done. Back panel, I think it's cool. Looks nice and very, very functional. And, you know, it's just overall this bag would have been probably my, if I could just fit my iPad mini. But again, I'm just dwelling on things that I can't fix now, and it is super cool. Overall build quality, this bag, it just feels super solid, very, very nicely done. And, you know, kind of surprised that it's still available because the quality of this thing is just fantastic. That all being said, let's dive into the main event. Let's talk about the main part of the bag. So let's undo these fidlocks, which again, some people don't like, but it's just the way this thing is designed. And then we've got a zipper that goes all the way around. Now again, not full clamshell because we've got this bottom situation going on, but if you had stuff in there, then it would be full clamshell to this section. This brings up one of the awesome design features they designed into this bag, which I didn't really notice at first, but then when somebody pointed it out, Coat of Bell actually pointed out to me, they said, "Have you noticed this little feature?" I said, "Oh my gosh, that is really cool." So what they incorporate in here is this nice little rain flap-ish kind of thing on the inside, but look at the styling. It has got this sort of sawtooth orange interior lining, which draws its inspiration from the old bomber jackets of old, which this is, you know, my old bomber jacket. But check this sucker out. So here's what they've done. This is what the old bomber jackets had, and some of them had orange on the inside. This one is the modern version, which is, you know, not that old, has that same weatherproof flap. So this is the summer weight didn't have that. The winter weight one did. You zip this sucker up and you got this rain barrier, not rain, cold barrier to just keep you warmer. So that's how that gets a little bit of military styling into this thing, which is just super, super awesome. And again, it goes, that little flap goes all the way around the top, just give you a little pop of orange as you're getting into the bag. I just think that thing's just super cool. I mean, I like that. I like that a lot. And again, it's one little design feature that just annoys me, but the rest is fantastic. So, but don't stress too badly. Where did I put my iPad mini? On the inside. They've got two stretchy pockets on the inside of this flap. Again, more orange little accents in there all the way around. We've got two stretchy mesh pockets in the top. I just, big enough for your AirPods, maybe a little charging thing. I've got a pair of sunglasses in the top, which is just nice. And at the bottom, here it is, the iPad mini. So it's with me, don't worry. And you could fit a little bit wider things in there, but the iPad mini fits perfectly inside, protected from the elements now. I just have to dig into the front to get it, but you know, I will soldier on. So there we go. This is the dimensions, or not dimensions. this is how this thing looks. And again, it's more kind of A-framed, A-shaped, with that big wide base, and it kind of tapers up to the top. So what's packed in here? We got five things. We have some in the smaller little shadow pocket, then we have two GR1 sized field pockets. Then we have a packing cube. I believe this is the 6 liter from Patagonia. And the bottom, we just had kind of rounding out that base because this thing kind of fit perfectly, the Mystery Ranch Huckberry Dop Spiff Kit, I think it is. So that thing just not totally decked out, but fits perfectly in the bottom part of the bag. On the back of the bag, we have, again, little EcoPack label, recycled materials, that kind of thing. And we have this stretchy pocket. So it's suspended from the bottom, and then, you know, do whatever you want with that thing. I don't, it's on the back, so maybe some papers, you know, that kind of thing. I'm not really sure. I tend to not use those kind of pockets a lot in my packing. Otherwise, this layer separating the two parts of the bag, if you wanted to overstuff that bottom part and put it all in here, super cool. The way that I'm kind of envisioning this is, say this was my big packing cube of clothes, and I would just pack it in here. I would go on my trip, and I would sort of use it like I would use a packing cube from Peak Design, where I take out my dirty stuff, maybe I don't put it back in there, and then I just put it on the bottom. So the bottom becomes my all my dirty laundry, venting all the stinkiness out, so it's not totally obnoxious when I get home, or just a pair of shoes with some dirty clothes in there. I don't know. You know, so that's sort of the genius of this one. Again, just really love this orange layer. And yeah, it's not really, like, I would say functional, because it's not, it's, you know, it's a protecting the interior from the cold, but I think it's a nice little weather barrier. And if you were going to add some styling to it, that's just a nice little awesome feature. There you go. So that's outside inside. Super solid build, nice design. I mean, 30 liters is kind of in a weird little section of volume, if you ask me, because it's a little too big for EDC, unless you really want to do a big EDC. If, you know, maybe that's what you need to carry every day, is a lot of stuff. This would be a great bag for you for weekend and weekend plus travel. This thing would do expertly. In fact, I'm considering it for an upcoming trip. More about that in an upcoming video, because I need some help. I have too many options when it comes to packing, and I just need your help. And we're gonna talk about that here. And let them bark. They can bark while I fix this up. That's fine. They're barking at nothing. They'll probably stop. There you go. That's this one. This is the 4020X Double Name Project 2 Harvest Label and Coat of Bell. And it's just got a lot of cool Coat of Bell, Hyplon tabs, a lot of little things here and there that really make Coat of Bell one of my favorites. Now, here's a chart. Of all the bags that I just wanted to look at the dimensions to see how they would compare to the 4020X. And there's some that are pretty close. But then when I handle this thing and I think about the features, and I really, I mean, it's the build quality of this thing is, it's top tier for sure. I just, there really wasn't anything that really directly compared to it. So here are the two closest. So I'll bring them out just so we can kind of see and talk through a couple of things. So this is the first one. It's 26 liter. Of course, this is the Phoenix edition, the CTB, Civic Transit Bag, from Evergoods. And but on your back it holds about the same, and I think that with its features, of course it's a little shallower, so that's where you get the 26 versus the 30 liters. You just have a little bit different bag, but in terms of direct comparisons, this is the best I got, man. And there's definitely differences with this: breathable back panel, side water bottle pockets, that kind of thing. No, you know, lid on the top, but it's the best I had. But it is a comparable in terms of build quality and everything else. The second one, in terms of just capacity, is this one, and in some styling, this is the M23 21 liter from GORUCK. So you're like, that's like 9 liters difference, right? Well, I did a video a while ago about the sizes from GORUCK. Most of them are pretty close, I would say, but the M23 is the one that's just way out of whack. Now, build quality is super awesome. Lots of external pockets. Its main selling feature for me personally. External accessible laptop area. Of course, there's a lid, non-removable. But in terms of styling build quality, this comes close, missing a couple things. But in terms of like stand height, depth, you know, this sort of just supports. Cotabel calls this 130. And the math on this one is it's much bigger than it leads you to believe. So, you know, again, nothing, it's in a class of its own and super fantastic build. So I love it. It is going to be, again, in my video next week or so, I'm going to tell you some of my two bag packing options. So I need something to go with this. So I'm going to think about that a little bit. But I, you know, this might be the one I take with me just because I can take water bottles, I can take a ton of stuff, super comfortable on my back, put my stinky stuff on the bottom, which will be important on that trip that I'm going on, and then just take little things everywhere you want to go. Man, do you love it? Here's the thing, it's still available. And most of these collaboration bags, man, they sell out like that. Not super expensive, available now, link in the description if you want to go pick it up. Ton of premium features. I mean, I was just shocked that I could still get this bag right now. And it's just awesome, super cool. Like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. More coming at you quick. It's probably a midweek video on this one. Just got a lot of things, just man, cranking through it. Trying to get you ready for the summer and the spring travel because hope you got big plans. See you in the next one. As soon as I say, maybe she'll stop, she doesn't stop. And we're back.